久呢，做完留学生之家这一期之后呢，有不少的留学生说，哎，我在美国遇到的寄宿家庭没有那么差。的确，在美国的寄宿家庭呢是各式各样的。今天我就带大家去拜访一家 ，Let's go。
Was Andrew the first one?、Mm-hmm. So was he your first、international student you host、
yeah.
in your family?
Yeah,、mm-hmm. yeah we've never done that before.、So.
What made you decide to host him?
We thought it would be a good opportunity to help some of these kids come in, introduce them to America, and let them see some things, family life and things like that.And we eat together, we go to the grocery store together, we find out what, you know, he likes to eat, tried eating some of the food that he wants us to eat, 、the duck tongues and the
duck feet,
the、yeah. duck feet and all this、yeah. other stuff, and it's,、we can tolerate it, the, you know, with the hot pot and everything else, we've enjoyed all that, but then he had to learn to eat our food、mm-hmm. and things here too.
This is Andrew's
knife.
中国、yeah. 中国的刀。
We have two freezers.
Mm-hmm.
We bought this one and then this one. My mother gave it. They, this is a lot of their stuff. We're good.
Dumplings.
Still have some of the. See, they still have some of their stuff down here. This is not clean. Yeah.
Whoa, whoa. It's lots of Chinese stuff.
Yeah, they just make themselves at home and all.
When you first hosted the Chinese student, how big was the culture shock to you? To both of you?
A lot. I think it was a lot.
It was a lot.
It was a lot.
When Andrew came in here, he was used to having someone do everything for him. Okay. He had never cleaned his room. He had never cleaned his bathroom. He said, I have a maid at home. And I said, well, this is Mrs. Shutt. She's my wife.She's not your maid, and you cannot afford her. So you're going to have to learn to clean your own room.
And so he did.
We took pictures of him learning to do that, and we sent it back to his mother. And she was all excited because he was learning to do some of these
and
things.
And when I taught him how to, him and Edwin were the first、yeah. ones I taught to, I said, now look, guys,、yeah. you are cleaning the bathroom. What? So I started showing
said,
him.
We're getting our hands
and,
dirty.
And I was like, there are gloves.、Yep. Put gloves on.And so they learned, and then when we started to clean the toilet, I said, this is what you do. And I looked, and they're both over there going,
This is Danny. And Danny likes to keep the window open. So.
Wow.
And this is Andrew's old room.
This is the room. We wanted to keep it as a guest room where people could come in. When Andrew's mom and sister-in-law came in, they were able to stay here.
Oh, wow. I love this room.
We just、yeah. repainted it. It was pink.
Yeah.
We had to get rid of
the pink
room
that right didn't like.
So now this is a guest room.
Yep.
Is this also a new bed?
Yes, this is、yeah. a new bed.
We had been saving for about a year、yeah. just trying to get some stuff because the things that we had were when we were younger and it was just older.
It was just old.
And we just wanted to be a bigger bed, make it more comfortable for the families when they got in.
How long does it take for you to paint all of this?
About 3 days.
Yeah, it took about 3 days.
Make money is not important for you、mm-hmm. to having them here. That's not the purpose. But you could, you know,、mm-hmm. because I heard in Potomac, McLean, they charge Chinese students for thousands、yeah. a month.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
But we don't do that.
They treat them like
and Andrew,
a hotel.
Andrew had a little attitude there for a while where that I pay you this every month. You need to do this. And we just sat him down one night and I said, buddy,You need to take a pen and a paper and write down, get some prices, what it would cost you to stay in a hotel. And then write down the prices that it would cost you to do your own laundry and to call Uber to take you to all the places that you go. And then to do all the things with you. I said, you couldn't afford us if we charged you for that.
I want to ask you how much you charge them. You don't need to tell me if it's too private, but I want the Chinese parents to know what's the range.
We don't charge them. I mean, they just give us a stipend, $1,000 or less, and groceries.
Do you think it's enough to cover your cost?
It wouldn't be enough to cover the cost, no.
Mm-mm.
No.
And they, I have to say, we've been very fortunate. We've had good kids each time.
Yes.
And we told them, even when they disagreed with us, I looked them both in the eyes. I said, guys, you may not agree with what I'm telling you, but you know we love you. Mm-hmm. And we're telling you this because this is best for you. Because if you don't love them, you don't need to have them in your home. Just be quite honest with you. If you're not going to learn to love these kids...and put up with some of the things and help them to get over that and do what's right, you ought not have it.
Yep.
It's not a money thing. It's worth it all when you get to see them graduate.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
He graduated with honors.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. He got accepted at 3 colleges. Okay. He had an opportunity to make a choice as to where he wanted to go. We tried to help him with that. And our labor...has not been in vain.
And he would
sometimes
ask
it seems like it is, and sometimes there are days I just want to pull my hair out、
mm-hmm.
and say, ship him back. Send him back. COD.
跟 Ray 和 Lisa 的这段采访呢，我们本来以为20多分钟就可以结束，结果呢聊了2个多小时。那么采访中我印象最深的就是他们俩会不停地说Andrew like this, Danny like this.
Danny likes to be outside more than Andrew. But Danny likes building the fire more than Andrew. Andrew has to be very careful with these. Danny can eat anything.
And he does.
And he does, yes.
对寄宿家庭的这两个孩子的任何兴趣爱好还有他们平时的活动都是如数家珍。我觉得他们可能比这两个孩子的自己的家长还要更了解他们。所以你对他们一家这四年以来你的感情怎么来形容？
就怎么说呢，就是感恩吧，就是怎么说，就反正比较感谢他们。说真的，他们没有义务去这样做，但就是他们对我真的很好。然后开演之后，等他们走了，然后瑞当天晚上就去了一趟银行，然后从他们的银行账户里面给我取了100美金出来。虽然说钱不多，但是真的就真的就当时他把钱递给我的时候就说希望这个能帮到你，我真的就非常感动。
其实我那天采访完他们，我特别感动的一点是他们也不是说很富裕的美国家庭，就是很普通的美国工薪家庭，就是他们其实完全他可以挣你更多钱的，但是他们没有，所以我当时的感触是挺深的。 Ruth 还好吗？妈妈还好吗？您是什么样的感觉？
嗯，怎么说呢，瑞他是一个 pastor，他对自己的信仰非常执着，然后，所以呢，他对待我的孩子呢，就像他对自己的信仰一样，他没有觉得这个孩子是一个有肤色的，是别的国家的孩子，他一直用他自己信仰的那种标准吧，去对待这个孩子，非常善待他，所以我确实非常感动，这里边的点点滴滴。真的不是拿一句话能说完。
听完这个寄宿家庭的故事，不知道大家是不是跟我一样很感动。在临走的时候，瑞跟我分享了一篇他专门为这一次采访写的文章，是关于他作为寄宿家庭的一点心得。寄宿的真正含义是接纳、招待、尽地主之谊，而当寄宿家长是一种荣幸、荣耀以及责任。更多的精彩内容，欢迎订阅并且下载凤凰新闻客户端以及凤凰秀。再会。Thank you.